Ahead of the House GOP's first impeachment hearing tomorrow, the House Ways and Means Committee unveiled today what Republicans are calling, quote, new evidence, suggesting a two-tiered system of justice and that President Biden used his political influence to enrich his son. But the two main pieces of evidence displayed were from 2017, when Joe Biden wasn't in office, and from August of 2020, when Donald Trump's Justice Department was in power. I pressed the committee chairman, Jason Smith, on this. First, he dodged my questions about why actions taken in the 2020, during the Trump administration was evidence against the Biden administration. And then I pressed him about how a 2017 message is evidence that Biden was selling his office when he wasn't in office. Take a listen.
Can you explain the timing then of the August 6th WhatsApp message? Why is that evidence of some wrongdoing?
I'm not an expert on the timeline. I would love to have President Biden and his family to tell us about all the timelines, because it's really, really unfortunate that we see so many meetings and so many phone calls that involved around official activity that the vice president has been participating in, and then big sums of money follows later.
But if he's not the president or the vice president at that time, where's the wrongdoing? He wasn't even a candidate for president at that time.
He was a candidate.
In August 6th of 2017?
Apparently, what source are you with?
I'm with NBC.
So apparently you'll never believe us.
I'm not saying I don't believe you. I'm asking you a very direct question. You presented a piece of evidence that you say came on August 6th, 2017, that demonstrates that Joe Biden was using political influence to help his son. He wasn't a political figure at that time, the first WhatsApp message you put up, where you talk about the brand. And I'm completely open-minded about this. I'm asking you specifically, how does that demonstrate that there's some sort of political influence being put over him if at that time he is not a political, he's not an elected official?
I'm definitely not going to pinpoint one item. I think we've outlined.
You presented it. It was your first thing that you brought up.
So apparently you don't agree with it.
It's not that I don't agree with it. I'm asking you to explain it.
I'll take the next question.
Thanks for watching. Stay updated about breaking news and top stories on the NBC News app or follow us on social media.